to the most important persons in the world, the children, our future. Today I shall just touch upon few very important aspects affecting all of us, especially the children, in this new normal times of COVID days. Coming straight away to it, I would like to say that there are three important aspects to keep us mentally and physically fit. Children, please listen. First one is diet, second is exercise, and third, screen time. Yes, screen time. As these are the new vital factors of a new way of life, especially the children. Now, coming to diet, we all know we have to have more, we have to give more attention to our diet because we have to build up our immunity. For that, we should eat the right kind of food and also the right amount. So, a lot of veggies, fruits of all colors, so that we get all our minerals, we get all our vitamins, and a good amount of zinc from the nuts. And I think I won't go into details, but it's very important to have healthy food. Most of us know what is healthy food. Then, of course, the children, especially growing children, should be having enough protein in form of milk, eggs, lentils, and also paneer, and non-veg too, like lean meat. These are very important things. And right amount of fat, not too much. Too many fried things, too many junk food is not good. Especially at this time, we have to be very careful. And now there's a tendency to overeat because we are at home. Our moms are baking a lot of cakes, making lovely, delicious food. But we can have them, but in moderation, because we don't have exercise, because most of us are at home, homebound, so no going to school. So exercise is less, so we should be very careful how much we eat, because these days we're having a lot of problem, children becoming overweight because they don't have enough exercise and they're overeating. So we have to be very cautious about our children because our health is so important. Then I'll come to the second part, that is exercise. As I said before, because we are all homebound, we are staying inside the house, not going to school, no traveling, no playing a lot outside. Hence, exercise is missing. So what do we do? So there's a very nice mantra. They say, do not sit less and walk more. So even at home, don't sit down all the time. Try to walk around. So sit less and walk around is a very good way of some kind of exercise. Then of course, in our layout, you can go out for a walk with the family. So walking outside in the neighborhood, which is quite safe, is also a good exercise. Then of course, you should try some fun exercise at home. Start learning yoga. You can do skipping. You can learn dance. Or even you can try balloon volleyball. That's a new thing I heard about. Very nice at home. You won't break anything if you play with balloon, jumping around, playing volleyball at home. You can even involve your parents. And then of course, I was surprised to find that people are making, bigger children, making movies on action movies. So this kind of new hobbies you can develop. So that will also make you exercise. So there are norms set for how much exercise is required by children. They say children, adolescents and school children should have at least 60 minutes of moderate to vigorous exercise every day. And muscle strengthening exercise 3 times a week. So there are a lot of details about how much exercise you should do to remain healthy. Younger children, there are other standards. In fact, they'll have more exercise because they'll be running around more than the bigger ones. But sitting in the couch, sitting watching the screen, it's not very good. Even if when you have online classes in between, you should walk around and take some exercise. So main thing is move more and sit less. And other kind of exercise you can do is you can help your parents, your mother, do some chores at home, cut the grass, help in such things. So that also is a kind of exercise and is so useful too. And that's a family time too. So there are a lot of good things during the COVID times where you can have more bonding with your family, get closer to them. We have to look at the positive side of that. Then coming to screen time. Now, this is a new thing we'll touch upon a lot because all the old norms for how much screen time should be allowed and all is gone because the standardization is no more the same. So now we have new standards. So actually more than screen time, it's the screen quality of screen time. So if you are, actually they say below 18 months, no screen, the parents should hear this. Below 18 months, you're not supposed to give any screen time. You are supposed to be talking to them. They're supposed to be interacting with living things, not on the screen. Except for supposing you're having a video conference with the grandchildren, grandparents or other relatives. babies also can interact. It's a kind of social interaction which is missing otherwise, because they're not mixing up with other people. So that is allowed now. The older children, and because actually they say below 5, only 1 hour a day should be allowed, unless it's a very quality kind of thing where there's educational things going on. And older children, according to the school, it will be there. So we can't do much about that. But the other time, they should not waste playing games and all that. Again, that's what means, that's what quality means. You should be looking at things which are useful, which are educational, socially useful, instead of wasting time playing games, especially now with half the time you're on the screen studying. Then a very important thing is something called co-watching. The children should not be alone. They should have either parents or some adult along with them. They should interact with them, discuss what they are watching. So that makes a lot of difference. So you will be looking at more developmental viewing. So co-viewing is very important, even older children, because the parents should know what they are watching. After all, they're children and they should not go the wrong way. So these are the three things I would have just, I think is very important for us. And of course, last but not the least, please children, you also should not forget hand wash, masking and social distancing. You're very important, because through you, you can spread the disease to your grandparents, parents and all that. So you also have to be very careful. Okay, this is very important. This responsibility is also on your children. So children, have a nice Children's Day. Keep safe. And lastly, I would also like to wish you a happy Diwali, which is coming. But please be careful again during the Diwali. Don't burst crackers, which will cause pollution. Because now itself, there are a lot of people who are post-COVID having difficulty in breathing. We have to think about them so that we don't increase the pollution. And so it's again in your hands. Green Diwali. I wish you a very happy Green Diwali. God bless you. Thank you.
Okay, so good morning all, and we have Uttu Pankal today addressing all the children of LSH, and we are here mainly to hear from him his childhood experience, you know, what it has been being a child, going through the childhood in like 60s, right? So
much earlier then.
Much earlier, okay. Yeah. That was an indirect compliment, okay. Yeah. So Uncle, can you hear from you, you know, how it had been?
I will start with what you asked me. It's not 60s. Actually, I am a freedom fighter, I can say that. The first decade of my childhood was the most climax of the freedom struggle. And I still remember, I was maybe in up to class, got independence, I think, when I was in class 5 or something. Before that, I still remember going for Jatha and Morcha and all that after the school class hours and saying Bharat Mata Ki Jai and all that. Still I remember those days. Right. I think when I was in class 5 or something, we got independence. Still that, it was independent struggle. And I still remember the first day when we started singing Jana Gana Mana, and the girls who were saying, they did not know, we are Malayalis, we are not used to that language. And there was somebody to teach them what is this Jana Gana Mana. And before that, we were singing that royal, because Kerala was under royal rule, Maharaja, okay. Praising and glorifying the Maharaja. That was our earlier Vanji Bhumi. I don't know whether somebody remember Vanji Bhumi Pade Chiram. That was the national anthem we were singing earlier. But thereafter, after independence, we switched over to Jana Gana. So most of that, about 10 years, my childhood was in during that period under British rule. And thereafter, we got independent. And after that, the childhood experience, if I have to say, it was really wonderful. The most memorable experience which I had in my childhood was early morning, we all get together and go for a swim. We never take bath at home. We got a river behind our
public house. Public water, it's wonderful. Yeah.
Deep, very wide and very clean river. So we all get together, and we were all together. We were all going into the same school, not different school, because there was only one school. So there all is right. No difference that you are going that school or this school. So that intimacy will be closer when we are in the same school and walking together and playing together always. So that was the experience. So we were, We used to go in the morning at about 8 o'clock for that swimming, and that is how I learned swimming. There was nobody to teach me swimming, or there was no swimming pool or no club or nothing.
Yeah.
It's a village. It's a typical village. So we go together, we enjoy nearly for about 1.5 hours, taking a bath in that river, then swimming. Nearly 1 hour, that was the most enjoyable time I had when I was a small child. Maybe about 10, 11 years or 12 years. During that time, I studied my, I learned how to swim. It's a deep river.
Right.
Actually,
okay.
Those friends, you know, they taught me, they helped me. I was really confident that I will not get drowned because they were all around me.
Yeah.
And that is why we all learned. That was a really wonderful experience of my childhood before I went to school. Then after that, the most wonderful experience which I had was going together to school. We all get together at one place. At that particular time, we go to school and we come back. And after we come back, that was the playtime. At about 4 o'clock, we come back from school, and then we all go to... it's a village, I told them it's a village.
Yeah,
we all had sheep, goat, and cows and all that. But cows, my elder brothers will take care of. We are 6 brothers. So my elder brothers will take care of the cow and ox and
so
all
you
that.
Share responsibilities.
Yeah, it is their responsibility. And I was in charge of sheep. We had 2-3. It was only for our home milk. So we all go together, everybody goes together. We got a nearby jungle. And we go there, take them, and we feed them. It's a good greenery, grass they can eat. And spend some time with them, and then we come home after feeding them. And during that time, after the sheep, we leave them, they will go and they will have their feed and they will come back. That time we will... go home. But
so there is
during,
a lot of time with the nature.
Yeah,
right?
during that time, we had enough time to play with. All our friends were there. They all will come at the same place near that jungle. After feeding sheep will go to the jungle or to the lair, the place where there are grass. They will eat, and they will be all right, comfortable. And then we have our own good time during that time. All
right.
Our friends together. It's
yeah.
really a memorable time during that.
True, true. I think the childhood for everyone is like something to sit back, relax and cherish on this particular day.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Is there any message for our little ones?
Oh, message for little one. And another childhood experience of mine which I will forget is, I told you we are 6 brothers and we sit together in the kitchen all together. All of them together, my father, my mother, and all 6 brothers, we sit together on the ground, on the floor, we sit together and eat together. He said, never I will forget. My mother used to serve each one of us, and we all sit together and eat together.
Right.
I really miss it. Because nowadays, you know, it is all commercial type. I come, I eat, children come, they eat. The togetherness in the family. It was a real experience in my life when I was...
No, I think eating together as well as eating or sitting on the floor, both of it. I mean, to an extent, if our kids could inculcate that...
Yeah,
it would
actually,
be good,
actually
right?
I will never forget in my life, and I really miss it now. I really, you know, you got dining table and everybody will have their own time to come and eat. But that was not the time. We are all together at that time. My father was very particular about it. All of you come and sit here, then only my mother will start serving food. Sit together.
Right.
That was a wonderful experience in my childhood, which I really miss now. And whenever I go home now, my mother is not there, father is not there, only my brothers are there. We try to meet. We meet together at least once whenever I go that time. So that was another memory which I will never forget. And of course, studies are also going on along with this when we come home for some time after the feeding.
But I guess it was never like for these kids, the current generation kids
No. We have our own time. And my parents, they were not bothered. They knew that the children will study, they should play, they should study. Everything was there. That freedom was there. So we will come home and we will sit together and we will study. We had only one room. All of us, we sit together and study there. For study room, there was only one place. And then the last about my advice or my message to the children is, there is a proverb which says, train the child when it is young, and he will never forget till he is old. So that is the time a child should be trained, how he should behave when he become youth or elder or what, during their life. That is very important. So that, and parents also has to play a role in that. It is not only the child, and because the life of a child depends upon the way the foundation of the child that is laid when they are very small, and they will never forget it, they will never deviate it, depart from that till they become old. And okay, so that is very important for the children, and the children should be told, according to me, that what is the moral values of their life they should uphold. They should uphold the moral values. Most importantly, they should stick to truth, honesty, respect to the elders, obedience, all these principles they should inculcate right from the childhood, then they will never forget. Respect to elders is very important, respect to parents is very important, obedience is very important. All these moral values they should uphold in their childhood, then they will not deviate it from even then they become old. This is the message which I have to give the children. I hope the children will go with this. We should learn from Mahatma Gandhiji. He lived for truth. He had nothing, not deviated from that. That is very important in our life. Truth, obedience, and moral principles, all other moral principles, especially helping others, like you people are doing, Nathan, Pavitra, and Prasida. You are all taking care of others. So they should have that training right from the beginning. Then only they will keep it up. So train them. When they are in the layout, you are all there. And I think they will learn from you also. And this is all what I have to say. Thank you very much for sparing your time and giving me this opportunity to give this message to the children.
Thank you very much, uncle. Thank it was lovely. I think as you summarized at the end, it is very important that there was a hidden message to parents as well, as to lead by example, right? You know, yes, you do it, so they see and, you know, they follow. So absolutely, I think be it kids or adults who have the child within them, there is so much for all of us to improve, to be a better human being. So absolutely, wonderful message, absolutely, lovely. Absolutely. Thank you so much for your time. Bye bye to Uthupankal for now. Okay, here we are at Kumar uncle's house, and can you believe this is one of his masterpiece, beautiful big painting in his living room. And let's go to the man of the show today. Hello, uncle.
Hello.
Okay, so we are very eager to hear from you, your childhood experience.
Yes.
What has been your favorite moments?
See, I must say with pardonable pride that I was born with a silver spoon. My wishes and desires were fulfilled by my dear father, who was a leading commercial photographer, artist, and one of the few people amongst the Britishers with whom he mixed well, and he was always been after by the social milieu. And I must say that with his far-reaching influence, with the celebrities and people who mattered, with their help, I could get admission into one of the best European boys' high schools. One we have in Lovely, that's near Coimbatore, near Ooty. And this was also a good school. And not many people could get admission to the school unless they have some influence and somebody to back them up.
So you were being very fortunate.
I was very fortunate that way. But my Indian schoolmates or classmates were all chocolate faces amongst the whites, who were rough and tough, and charitably, not charitably disposed to us, though. And those were the halcyon days, which I cannot forget. They will never come back to us again.
True, true. I think everyone's childhood has been very special and very personal to self.
Yes.
Right. So what has been your playtime like?
My playtime, soccer was the first love for all students or my friends in the neighborhood. They were all soccer lovers.
Oh.
Yes. I would say with compulsion, that it is like Bengal. Because their food habits, rice and fish, like Bengalis.
Okay.
Kerala. Right. I was in North Malabar, that is called the British Malabar.
Okay.
That is called the British Malabar in those days. I think you might have heard the place Kannur.
Kannur, yes. Kannur. Right.
And nearby is Talisheri.
Mm-hmm.
Talisheri is a place where artists were produced, circus artists.
Okay.
And that's the only place in our country, I think, with circus artists,
mm-hmm.
as many people may not know.
Mm-hmm.
And you must understand, the Britishers had even their academy, cricket academy in Talisheri.
Okay.
Yes.
Is it the same, the Talisheri biryani that we have?
Exactly, exactly. You have the Talisheri biryani.
Oh, wonderful, okay. Now I can relate more. Yeah. But given those days, for a child, it was a lot of emotional turbulence also, right? There is
exactly.
So much happening in the country.
Yes. It was a traumatic experience for all the children of those days.
That's right.
Because their elders were persecuted. They were tortured. All these things happened before their eyes.
Correct. And something so much more than they can comprehend and digest.
Exactly, exactly. But nevertheless, we have not lost our hopes. Our elders looked after us well. And the first thing that they do is, they never bothered about the families. They were bothered about the deity in the temple.
Mm. Ah, okay.
They used to take away the murti, the idol, inside the temple. And it was hidden somewhere in the same place, but they wouldn't be able to find it out. There were small wells also.
Mm-hmm.
There will be a cellar inside the well.
Okay.
It will be kept inside somewhere. And again it will be cemented. And you will see, when you open, you will see it's only a well. There's no opening to go inside.
Mm.
Such places were there to hide all this precious.
So were you playing hide and seek then?
Exactly.
Hide and seek with the real valuables.
For a bank information,
mm-hmm.
Talisheri and Kannur was connected through a sea route.
Okay.
There was a cave which connected Kannur and Talisheri. It's hardly about 14 kilometers or so.
Okay.
And they managed to go to Talisheri or come to Kannur, whichever way, and again seal it.
Oh, okay.
Now all that is dilapidated and people don't go through those caves.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Is there anything that you really miss the most from your childhood? Like some specific moments?
See, I had a traumatic family life. In the sense, my father died at the age of 41. And you understand, I was in my teens. I was hardly 14 years old.
Yeah.
And at the age of 14 years, how do you expect a boy to react to that situation? He would fall back upon his people, his relatives or whoever it is. In my case, there were two uncles. Soon after my father's death, they deprived us of all our fortune, whatever my father had left behind. We were virtually on the street. Nobody to take care of. Now tell me, a boy of 14 years of today, will he be able to face that life? When nobody is turning to you for succor, for help, nothing is done. It was really painful. I loved them so much. And I even told them, I begged them, take whatever my father has. I don't want it.
So how did this little boy cope up with the situation and did so well?
It's God's grace. And another thing is, you know, a very traumatic day of mine, which if you want, I will prepare to say that.
Sure, you can talk about it, uncle, if you don't mind sharing. I think any story for that matter has a lesson to learn. See, yes. Today we are recording this video for our children to know. Back then life was much more difficult.
Yes, exactly.
Right. So, please go ahead.
Yes. So, my father's popularity, my father's abilities, all these were backing us to some extent, because even without learning anything, I could manage to learn photography through the books he left behind.
Okay.
I browsed through those. It's not like a computer to browse.
Those
pages. Those books were like computers. And I could assimilate and digest whatever I could. And you must understand, at that age, I don't know what a camera was, what a lens was, what a chemical was that I'll be using for it. And you know, my uncles managed his studio and they left it all totally like an invasion.
Mm-hmm.
When there's an invasion in your land, you find
behind.
Your land.
Right.
My father's property. One thing, you know, at that age, I took care of my sister in all possible ways, educated her, and at the age of 20 or 21, I got her married also. Marriage is something which is a responsible job, which nobody can do at the age of 20 or 21.
Yeah.
Marriages are conducted when the head of the family is about 50 or 55 or 60.
Yeah.
It is at that point in time the children get married or do whatever they wish to do.
True.
In my case, I was thrown out virtually, like a baby thrown out of the tub water.
Absolutely. So I think you had that responsibility coming to you much before your age.
Responsibility.
But
at the age of 21, I got her married, got her settled, and I was so happy that her three children. One is a leading pediatric surgeon, and of the two daughters, one is a banker, banker, officer, and the other is a beautician and an accomplished Bharatanatyam dancer.
Wonderful.
They are all well off by God's grace.
Yeah.
And I'm so proud that I could do something about it.
True. I think it's a proud moment for any parent when the kids excel so well in life in the field of their interests.
No,
my
only fear is that the children of today have to take a responsibility that has to be inculcated right from the beginning.
Yeah, guys, kids, if you're watching this video, listen to this carefully. So it makes a lot of sense, yes.
So,
not everything could be spoon-fed, so learn from experience.
I've been a vagabond.
Yeah.
Or even a churlish boy.
Right. But I think the situation demanded something else from you.
Exactly.
Right.
And I know by God's grace, and with my own steam, I could do whatever I can and manage my predicament.
That's wonderful. It's more like a success story. So when you look back now, the sense of satisfaction to have swam through the water so well must have been really good, right?
Yes.
So I think we as parents also somewhere we take too much care of our kids, not giving them much responsibility.
Yes.
So I think something that we can also
stop too much of spoon feeding.
Yeah.
And you should leave it to them to do certain things
right.
on their own.
And one thing for sure, these days kids have their own mind, their own thoughts. I think we should somehow slow down at some point and allow them to take over even, you know, at least smaller tasks,
exactly,
and smaller decision making.
Exactly.
Wonderful.
And by the way, incidentally, I share my birthday with the great man, great statesman, Jawaharlal Nehru.
And now comes the special message from Kumar Uncle to all our children of LSH.
Dear children of Lakeshore Homes Collective, you have a great duty to perform and accomplish towards your parents, society, state, and nation. Essentially, learn to respect your elders and imbibe the best qualities of head and heart, character building, and contribute the best of your knowledge. Be warm, cheerful, friendly, and bring out your charm. Your happiness depends on what you can give and not what you can get. At once, it teaches us that giving happiness is more joyful than getting it. And I know the collective has been in the forefront these days. The COVID-19 has taught lessons to us to be charitable to people who are downtrodden and have nothing in their lives. Your happiness depends on what you can give and not what you can get. At once, it teaches you that giving happiness is more joyful than getting it. Having said that, such noble action upholds human values regarded by all religions as love, kindness, compassion, empathy, helpfulness. All these are predominant principles in human life. In fine, giving need not only be something we do for others. In a way, it essentially makes us connect with ourselves, to being human. When you laugh and reject your sense of pain, you come out a winner. But when you keep on grumbling, your problems go on increasing all the way. That reminds me of my favorable phrases, attitudinal gains and attitudinal loss. I think you might have heard about this.
True, very deep message indeed it carries.
And as Sir Winston Churchill had said once, attitude is a little thing that makes a big difference.
True, absolutely.
Every so often, any success that you do have is despite your fear, not because of it. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Uncle. There's so much of deep meaning to each of the phrases that you just spoke to our kids. I'm sure there is so much to learn, not just for the kids, also for the adults who have the child within them. So we better bring it out. All right. Thank you very much.
Last but not the least.
Yes.
I think I have to thank the cultural committee and the organizers who were involved with this, to have given me this special opportunity to speak to you.
And here is some of Uncle's work. Tanjore paintings. And these are some of his oil painting, acrylic painting with a lot of techniques. Sorry, I don't know much about it, but look at it, wonderful pieces. And best thing is, he says he is self-taught artist, so this is really amazing. And this one is our favorite today. Okay, here we have in Pratibha Kulkarni auntie's house and with her little one here. Hello.
Hello. Hi, Mana. Say hi, Sayesha.
Okay. So, we would be very eager to hear from you, auntie. How has your childhood been?
See, whenever I think of the pandemic here and how badly our children have been affected. All the children, not only in LSH, but outside also. I always think of what a carefree childhood we had.
True.
Maybe we didn't have too much of money. In those terms, we didn't have the TV, we didn't have so many gadgets. But I still think we had the most beautiful childhood. Because what was our entertainment was reading from books. And our elders used to make the books come to life. And I grew up in Mumbai.
Mm-hmm.
And my uncle was a Maharashtrian. So he would actually read out the classics from Marathi and tell us the meaning, the poems, and you know, make us aware of Marathi literature. On the other hand, my parents, both of them, used to make us aware of the English classics. And so we had a very like eclectic range of literature, both English, a lot of it Hindi, and this. Okay, and the hardships didn't matter. The fact that we didn't have many clothes to wear. We had a garden and we used to roam freely in it. Pick the guavas off the tree, eat them. When the custard apples were ripe on the tree, we would take the custard apples from there, wash them and eat them. And a Cadbury chocolate was like a big treat for us.
Yeah, right.
Yes, but it didn't matter. All those things didn't matter. Those are the memories of my childhood, you know.
Right.
The carefree this, the walk through 3 kilometers to school and back. See, we used to walk 6 kilometers every day, but we weren't aware of all those things. I studied in a convent school, which was 3 kilometers from my home. And so we used to walk, my younger sister and I, used to walk to school and back.
Mm-hmm.
I used to remember the earliest, like, I studied in a convent school, so every Friday was Adoration Day. So
mm-hmm.
we all had to go down on our knees and say the Hail Mary and the Holy Mary and things like that. So, but all those things became so much a part of me that even today, though basically I'm a practicing Hindu, but even today, if somebody tells me, look, here's a person in need. Please pray. What is the easiest thing I think of? Okay, let me say 20 Hail Marys, 20 Holy Marys. Let me say, come on. And that's, see, so a multi-religious background, you know, nothing so like compartmentalized into everything. Everybody was with us, part of us. Our neighbors were Muslims. They would call us for Eid. We would celebrate with them in a grandest possible way. Didn't matter who is, what is, didn't matter. All it mattered was that we were all together.
Right.
You know, I think that is a big lesson that
true.
Our children should, like, garner from.
No, build the bond with people, right? I think you build memories with it.
Yes.
So it's wonderful to cherish.
I built a lot of memories with it.
Mm-hmm.
I cherish those memories. And even today, like my nephew and his wife and his family, they're here all the way from Goa. They drove 14 hours to come and be with us. Because it's 8 months since they've seen us. And he's in Merchant Navy, so he comes once in 10 months. This time he was 11 months outside. After that he came. So I think that is more important, building relationships with people.
True.
Gadgets are there, but
the characters don't come out of gadgets. You eventually need people around.
Yes. We always will need people around. And
true.
I think that's the most important lesson our children should learn.
Yeah. I think the social presence, social life. I mean, at the end of the day, we human beings are like social animals.
That is what is the most important thing.
Right. Indeed.
Yeah. Okay.
Wonderful.
The most important thing in life, I think, is to build relationships and to be of use to society in some way or the other. That's what our children should learn. Of how much use can they be in their own society? What difference can they make to humanity?
True, wonderful. Thank you and bye-bye.
हमारा मेरा बचपन पूरा ग्वालियर में बीता है. हम लोग हिंदी मीडियम में पढ़े हैं, इसीलिए माफ़ करना, मेरे को इंग्लिश उतना अच्छे से नहीं आता.
चलेगा आंटी, दौड़ेगा.
बात करती हूँ. तो हम लोग, मेरी एक बहन एक भाई है. मेरे माँ पिताजी, हम लोग तिरुपति घूमने गए थे. तो ऐसे घूमते घूमते मैं पिताजी का हाथ पकड़ी थी और मेरी मम्मी मेरी छोटी बहन को गोद में ली थी. तो हम लोग जाते जाते मैं दुकान देखते देखते मेरे पिताजी का हाथ छोड़ के दुकान देखते रही और वो लोग आगे निकल गए और मैं बिछड़ गई और मैं रोने लगी. मैं बिछड़ गई और मैं रोने लगी. तो कहाँ गए पिताजी? और मेरी मम्मी क्या करती, एक कपड़ा लेके दोनों को एक जैसी फ्रॉक बनाती थी.
अच्छा.
तो मैंने क्या किया, एक पुलिस वाला वहाँ से जा रहा था तो पुलिस भैया तो बोले क्या हुआ? तो मैं रोते रोते बोली मेरे माँ पिताजी घूम गए हैं, मैं क्या करूँ. तो कहाँ, तुम्हारे पिताजी का नाम क्या है? तो उन्होंने कहा, मैंने कहा कि VMR शर्मा. अच्छा, फिर क्या और कुछ निशानी? तो वो मैं बोली मेरी बहन में ऐसी फ्रॉक पहनी है, यही ऐसी प्रिंट का फ्रॉक पहनी है. तो क्या इतना भीड़ में कहाँ ढूंढेंगे? फिर भी वो मेरी मम्मी भी मेरे पिताजी भी देखे, बच्ची नहीं दिख रही, वो लोग भी ढूंढते आ रहे थे और पुलिस वाला मेरा हाथ पकड़ के ले जा रहा था. तो सामने से वो देखो वो फ्रॉक पहनी है, हाँ वो ही है करके फिर.
अच्छा, तो मिल गए.
मिल गए, नहीं तो मैं इतना घबरा गई थी, मैं माँ पिताजी से बिछड़ गई, जैसे पिक्चर में दिखाते ना दो भाई बिछड़ गए.
तो जो भी वीडियो वॉच कर रहे सारे जुड़े बच्चे एक ही टाइप के फ्रॉक या पैंट पहन के जाओ.
तो मेरी मम्मी जो भी त्योहार होता है एक ही जैसे फ्रॉक पहनाती थी, एक ही जैसे कपड़े का.
फिर से कहीं घूमो चाहे तो मिल जाए.
नहीं नहीं, तो ऐसे इसीलिए वो यादगार मैं कभी नहीं भूल सकती. अच्छा. इतना साल हो गया लेकिन मेरे को वो कभी नहीं भूल सकती. और बच्चों, मैं बोलती हूँ आप लोग कभी घर के अंदर मत बैठे रहो, बाहर निकलो, खेलो, आउटडोर गेम्स ज़्यादा खेलो, जिससे तुम्हारी बुद्धि वृद्धि होगी. और अच्छे अच्छे किताबें पढ़ो, अच्छे अच्छे गांधी जी नेहरू जी का सब अच्छे किताबें पढ़ना चाहिए. और ज़्यादा कंप्यूटर में गेम्स वगैरह खेलने में अपना ये आँख खराब होता है. और कोई भी अपन बुक्स पढ़ते हैं तो एक इंच का दूरी रखना चाहिए, एक स्केल का 12 इंच का दूरी रखना चाहिए, तब आँख खराब नहीं होता है. और बड़े लोगों का इज्जत करो, बड़े लोगों का नाम कहाँ जो बोलते हैं वो सुनो बात, और अच्छी अच्छी कहानियाँ पढ़ो. बस मैं और क्या बोलती हूँ सब.
Hi, my name is Madhubi and I am 74 years old now. Being youngest in my family, I really miss spending time with my 6 brothers and sisters and mostly my school friends with whom I am still in touch with. You know, when I was 8 years old, I invited all my school friends to my house for my birthday without telling my parents and elders. That day they played along and treated us with tasty treats and cake too. I got a good scolding next day, but me and my friends had gala time never to forget. When I see kids playing today, I remember and miss playing my favorite game, mainly basketball. I just want to tell all the little ones to respect your elders, love your siblings and friends, laugh, cry, smile, fight, play, study, and have lots of fun so that you also have sweet memories like I still do. Thank you.